What is up? This Ace Bull Nappy. And y'all, I slick almost had a panic attack. Let me tell you why. So today's wash day for me, Sunday night, and it's my deep conditioner treatment because I like to style my hair for the week so I can leave it alone and not mess with it. So some of you been following me and you know that I straightened my hair for the first time in over 6 months. So the heat that was put in my hair, I feel like my hair was super sensitive to it. And it's a learning process because as I was in the shower, shampooing my hair, literally I felt no curls. And I'm like, where are my curls? Like I let the water really like just, I just let the water run on my head for like 3 minutes. And I was like, that's a fairly long time. Like I should feel some texture. My hair felt like a perm. I was like, no, 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 no. This can't be real. Like I automatically started going into panic mode. So I washed my hair with a 2-in-1 shampoo conditioner from Suave. Really cheap, $2 2-in-1 shampoo. I don't spend much on shampoos because I really don't see the need to. The other shampoo that I would use is like a daily cleanser clarifying shampoo from Suave, and it's like $1.79 because the soap that I'm using in my hair is going to get washed out down the drain. So I don't see a necessary reason to buy like an expensive shampoo. However, look at these stringy parts. If you guys seen pictures of my hair, and I'll insert them, my hair is coily, like coily. And these straight parts are scaring me to death. Like literally, y'all. Has anybody else gone through this? Like you straightened your hair, you were scared to do the heat anyway, and then you decided to do it. You did it professionally and then you started, you know, doing it yourself to keep your style, and then your hair just went out of whack. Because I'm not blaming anybody. I'm not blaming my stylist. I'm not blaming myself. I used heat protectant. I use heat at a certain temperature. I just don't know. My hair is just, it's something that I'm learning every single time I do my own hair. I've been doing my own hair now for a year straight. My big chop date was October the 25th, 2017. Today is December the 8th, 2018. So it's been a little bit over a year that I've been doing my own hair, learning my own hair. It's been great, but I'm rambling because I'm literally still in panic mode. So my next move, what I'm going to do with my hair is deep condition it. I'm going to deep condition it for 2 hours. I'm going to go in with my Babassu and Mint oil deep conditioner from Mielle Organics because I do hear it is like the best. It has allure, recognition, in the natural hair community. People have said it's holy grail. So I'm literally praying and hoping that my curls bounce back because my style is all going to depend on that. Right now, the front of my hair is super loose, which typically I have a looser front, but this is like way loose. Like I never can see like that much length when I wash my hair. Usually my shrink is just tight, like the back of my hair. I can't even really get it good without showing you guys this messy room. But the back is still kind of tight, not even as tight as it normally is. And even the crown of my hair is loose. And it's just like, I stopped my straight hair. It was going to be 2 weeks, but I stopped it at 1 week because after maybe like 4 days of trying to style it, I just couldn't do it anymore. Like the heat, waking up earlier to style it was just too much. And I was like, let me get my hands out of my hair and go back to my protective styles. I asked my niece, I said, what style should I wear? She said, your coils, finger coils, boom. Great idea. I don't have to touch my hair. That's my goal for tonight. But if that does not work out, Lord Jesus, stay tuned. Okay, y'all, so here I am with my deep conditioning cap on. And basically, let me tell you, I pretty much used half of this jar of the Babassu Mint deep conditioner by Mielle. Okay, thank God I bought this on Black Friday and literally got it for, I want to say $6, because I just went through this stuff. Like, it's almost gone. Like, I'll get one more use out of it and then I'm done. So for $6 and two uses, I say it's worth it. But at its full price, no, I won't be able to afford it. So basically, this is the process. I followed the instructions exactly.
So the instructions were as follows. To apply the deep conditioner to clean damp hair, part your hair in four sections, which I did, and apply it from root to tip. This product has so much tingle in it. Like, I know it's doing something. My head is tingling. It's very, very minty. The smell, to me, is strong, but I like it a lot. And it's doing something. I did start to see my curls forming as my hair was beginning to dry. So I was thankful for that. I saw my coils and my curl form coming back to its own without anything on it. It was just drying from being soaking wet. So I have a good feeling that after this deep conditioner that we'll be able to get into the finger coil styles. But stay tuned, okay? Hey, you guys, I'm back. So I've washed and then deep conditioned my hair. I actually let the deep conditioner stay on for 3.5 hours. Just kind of got caught up, got lazy, and I'm out of breath because I ran upstairs after my shower to get back on camera to show you guys my wet hair. So here is the front. Still some straight pieces. So we'll see what the gel will do. Once I style it, I'm still gonna go for the finger coils. So that's the plan. Hopefully my hair will start to tighten up and coil with the products that I'm gonna use. And I'll come back. I'll actually show you guys the products I'm gonna use today for my styling. And by the way, as far as the conditioner, I can't say that I love this conditioner. Because it wasn't very thick, and I feel like my hair really adjusts well to thick products. So I can't say that I loved it. After my second use that I'll get out of that, I'll definitely see how my hair reacts to it. Look at my hair. It won't even stay pinned down. But yeah, I'll have a better honest review about the conditioner after I give it another use. First, I'm going in with the Main Choice Growth Oil. To actually apply it directly to my scalp. So this is a multivitamin scalp nourishing growth oil. It is a naturally stimulating oil blend made exclusively for the scalp, formulated to help revitalize and rejuvenate the scalp. Our revitalizing oil is potent, yet gentle enough for daily use or as often as needed to transform your hair into a much healthier state. Gentle enough for daily use, lightweight and non-greasy, leaves scalp feeling revitalized and conditioned. So it is no mineral oil, no petroleum, no parabens, no sulfates, no formaldehyde. I think I said that wrong. Helps to reduce shedding, helps to revitalize and rejuvenate scalp. Naturally stimulating oil soothes and conditions the scalp, helps transform hair into healthier state for all hair types. Infused with biotin and vitamin C and D. So I'm using those four parts, those four sections I made to begin. Just kind of massage that in into the scalp. And then I'm going to go within those sections and add a little bit more. Making sure I get my edges.
So just for today, I've used about this much. This is a brand new bottle.
The next product I'll be applying to my hair is the Eden Body Works Natural Deep Conditioner Jojoba. I don't rinse this product out. It actually works very well with my coils to keep my hair moisturized. So this goes in first. And the way that I apply it, because it's a thick consistency like this, I take a little bit. It's very thick. Put it in my hands to warm it. And even with this much in my hand, each section will just get one hand. Oh, look at my clip stuck. Woo, okay. So just this one hand is enough for this section. You don't want to overdo this product. And I start it at the roots and then bring it on down to the tips. And that is enough. And then I'll go ahead and grab the clip from this section. And I had it already warmed in my hand. And I start with my roots and work it down to my ends. So you guys can see this is my natural curl right now, before it's defined. And I just finger part, not using any tools to obtain this hairstyle, but I am going to keep my hair in sections. Typically I would have gone ahead and done the back, but right now I'm just going to move to my second step. And this is the Mielle Pomegranate and Honey Leave-In Conditioner. So I take one pump, warm it in my hands, and work that one pump through both sides of my hair. Honestly, I really like this because it smells amazing. And any of you that use this product, you know exactly what I mean. And I get a lot of compliments because people will smell my hair. For the first couple of days, I say like the first 2 days of me wearing my style, and they're like, oh my gosh, what does that smell? And I always say, I think it's my hair. So thank you, Mielle, for that, for this great smelling product.
We say words that don't mean a thing, but when you're holding me tight,
so basically I'll show the process of how I style my hair, starting with the back, because I always start with the back and I always end with the front, and I work my hair in that order because honestly it just feels most natural to me to work from the back to the front. I never work from the front to the back. That just doesn't feel natural for me. So check out this clip. Here are the steps to show you how I complete the finger coils.
So this process can take quite some time. I say even anywhere between 2 hours and 3 hours. So it's already like 10 o'clock at night. I'm probably not gonna finish till after midnight, but that's because I deconditioned for 3.5 hours instead of doing my normal like 2 hours. So that's on me, but I am gonna come back to the camera and show you guys the front once I start working on it. So see you then.
Y'all, this is depressing. I know it shouldn't be that deep, but my hair has lost texture, and this is what I will call heat damage. My coils are here in the back. I'm gonna show you guys that. I think I'm truly satisfied with them, and I'm happy that the back of my hair has its act together. But this, I don't even know how to correct this. I don't even know if a 2-strand twist would cause my hair to curl. Like, I tried to bounce it up. I mean, it's like, it's pitiful. This means no heat in 2019. I don't think I'm gonna mess with it. Here I'm looking at my hair, just taking a look at it all over. In the front, these curls are so loose, and I'm just really disappointed. But I have to finish styling, and I wanna show you guys the process of me completing my hair in the front. So when I take the clip down, I'm using my finger to part a small section of my hair. And then I had to clip the rest away. And as I grabbed that piece of my hair that I separated, I'm just going to apply a good bit of the Wetline Extreme Gel. Enough to coat that piece of hair. And I mean like really coat it. So I'm going to go back for a little bit more and put it directly on the ends. And just using the smoothing method to not disturb the curls. So I began to twist a piece of hair starting in the middle of the shaft and then focusing on the ends. Not really paying attention to the root because I don't want the hair suctioned to my scalp. I really want it to hang. Again, twisting from the middle of the shaft of hair that separated. And then going in a circular motion, I'm trying to concentrate on keeping the motion going the same way. So I believe I was going clockwise. So I pretty much keep doing the same process. And then again, using the smoothing method to bring the product from the root to the tip. And this time I'm holding the root. This helps the root from being too fluffy. Paying attention to the very ends of my hair so that can also be defined. You don't want undefined ends. Not for this hairstyle, at least. I think.
Yay, I finished. It's 1 in the morning.
And this is what I'm doing to get my curls to do what they supposed to do. This is the strangest I've ever seen my hair, literally, because of all the straight pieces. I learned this from Nay Too Curly, to pick your curls up, let them fall, and doing this while the hair is still wet. Of course, on dry hair, it ain't gonna do nothing. So I gotta re-moisten these because they are dry as a rock. But yeah, all I'm gonna do tonight is to tie my hair down, and then in the morning I'll wake up and go from there. But woo, my hair is growing a lot, I could tell. I'm sleepy. Good night. This is how I get ready for bed. I get my large scarf. This may be satin or silk. I got it from the beauty supply store. And I fold it in half. And I turn the shorter half over and place it on my head. Let me show you guys the back so you get an idea of how your hair looks before you tie it down. And then I just bring the scarf around the back and tie the two strings securely, not too tight. I don't want to get a headache. And I bring it down to cover my curls and just tie it in a bow. And now I'm ready for bed. Good night, everyone. Thank you for watching. I hope you all liked this video. Like, comment, and subscribe.